If you're a fan of what tends to be considered indie music, you most likely have at least heard of the powerhouse group known as Peach Pit that began rocking the indie scene all the way back in 2016. The quartet, made up of rhythm guitarist and lead vocalist Neil Smith, lead guitarist Chris Vanderkooy, bassist and background vocalist Peter Wilton, and drummer Mikey Pascuzzi, all hail from Vancouver, British Columbia, producing what has gone on to become what is known as a mix of surf rock, lighter, sad rock, and what the band has coined chewed bubblegum pop that can only really be described as Peach Pit. A couple of weeks ago, they released their sophomore album, entitled You and Your Friends, on Columbia Records, and it has been stuck in my head every single day since I listened to it. It actually took me a couple of days to get in that first listen, and I'm not really sure why, but once I did, I entered another state of being. On a more serious note, it's honestly one of the best records I've ever heard, and today I want to talk a little bit about why. So I was first introduced to these Canadian boys back in 2017, when Robbie from Cavetown covered Drop the Guillotine on his channel. He later ended up talking about them again in another video about some music that he liked, and I think that's when I first actually sat down to listen to them. On a side note, before we continue, Neil pronounces it Drop the Guillotine, and I cringe inside every time I hear it. Neil, for some reason, if you're watching this by some godforsaken miracle, let me talk to you, bud. You're wrong. It's wrong. Alright, glad we cleared the air on that one. Anyways, before we get to You and Your Friends, I want to go into a little bit of the band's history, just so that there can be a bit of prior knowledge. Peach Pit's first release, Sweet F.A., which I believe stands for Sweet Fuck All, was released on May 13th, 2016, and featured four tracks. The somber, self-titled Peach Pit, the energetic 17, the stripped-down, sad version of Drop the Guillotine, and the rocky Sweet F.A. While it gave only a minor glance at the talents of this group, it held a lot of promise in terms of what was to come, and helped build the hype for the next release, Being So Normal. Their first album was released on September 15th, 2017, with a wide array of sounds. The refurbished Drop the Guillotine offered a new, more energetic take on the song. The title track, Being So Normal, brought a moving, yet somber tone, while the groovy dance track, Techno Show, lifted your spirits back up. Alrighty Aphrodite brought an uneasy, sinister tone to a classic tale, while Chagu's side turn satisfied a more goofy, weed-centric lifestyle, and Not Me made you just want to dance and move. But then the last third of the record was really quite depressing in nature. Hot Knifer was a very stripped-back, slow kind of track, whose first 2 minutes featured only rhythm guitar and bass. It offered a sort of reflective-sounding tone, something that you really just want to sit there and bob your head to. Next came the explosion that was Private Presley. An enticingly intricate guitar riff reels you in, while the reverse guitar, steady beat, and somber bass keeps you there. Incredibly moody and backed by strings throughout the song, the track traverses three verses and three choruses before fading out, only to be brought back by an intense and commanding guitar solo that somehow makes you want to headbang and cry at the same time. It carries on through a wall of building distortion and anger, only to end in an instant and lead into the closer track, Tommy's Party. Tommy's Party, the longest track on the record at about 6 minutes, is a very slow, somber, relaxing cut. It details a party Neil went to a couple of years back through the perspective of his friend Tommy, who throughout the song conveys how much he misses the good old days, when he and Neil would hang, and how he now sees that same happiness and enjoyment in whatever girl Neil was with at the time. It's backed up by slight homosexual subtext, long emotional guitar solos, and ends the record on a really pretty note. The downcast tone of the record is also reflected in the cover art, which displays an intimate exchange between two people at a party, captured by one another, yet seemingly hesitant. Being So Normal was an incredible first album, and helped rocket the band into success. After the release, they began steadily touring around North America, Europe, and Asia. They've played festivals like Bonnaroo and CBC Musical Festival, and even opened for Two Door Cinema Club for their 2019 tour. They also released a cover of Sufjan Stevens' song, Did I Make You Cry on Christmas Day? Well, you deserved it, on December 15th, 2017, putting a really pretty spin on an already pretty song. And now we finally get to You and Your Friends. The album was released on April 3rd, 2020, and was backed by the singles Feeling Low, Fuckboy Blues, Shampoo Bottles, and Black Licorice, in that order. With 12 songs, it reigns in at about 41 minutes, and is a jam-packed 41 minutes at that. Before we start, I want to mention that at first, I wasn't actually a huge fan of the singles. I didn't think they were necessarily bad, but they just didn't really hold up to me. But after I ended up listening to the full record, they ended up really, really growing on me, and Black Licorice is actually now one of my favorite songs off of it. Regardless though, the record opens up with Feeling Low, an energetic track that swings you into the old Peach Pit groove, guitar solo and all. Next is Black Licorice, an acoustic backtrack with an incredibly catchy chorus. The song is bouncy, upbeat, and one that I think helps to capture the tone of the album really well. The lyrics are pretty sad, but the song sounds happy and hopeful, something that ends up pretty frequently throughout the album. The first non-single is Next with Figure 8. With that comes a couple of things. One, on YouTube, it brings one of a couple of drawings slash animations done by Gaya Kesten, art that beautifully complements these tracks. And two, it brings an incredible fucking song to drive to. I was coming home from work one night and decided to pop this on, and I've come to the conclusion that the only right way to listen to the song is blasting this with the windows down, wind blowing, and the sun setting. The verses and pre-chorus build for a really groovy, rhythmic chorus, and really just makes you bob your head. Next up is the peppy, clippy, and once again, incredibly catchy puppy grin. The shortest song on the album, it has an infectious first guitar riff backed by a vigorous beat that really gets you dancing. Next up is Brian's Movie, a song that shares a couple of parallels with Tommy's Party. The song title is an obvious reason, but on a deeper level, it focuses on losing a friendship to a significant other. Neil mentioned previously that it was actually the story of how his two parents met, and is told through the perspective of his dad's best friend, who doesn't want to lose him to his girlfriend. It even actually gets a little possessive as well, implying some sort of romantic attraction, just like in Tommy's Party. The song itself uses slide guitar a couple of times for a unique sound, and is overall a really good song. Finally, to end out the first half of the record is the fucking beauty that is Camilla, I'm at Home. I would say that this is probably my favorite song on the record, and best believe I'm gonna tell you why. It has a really calm, ethereal, ambient feel, something that makes you want to move your arms to the air while you're driving down the highway at night. I know this, because I've also done this. The vocals are calm and muted, and complement the delayed and reverb guitars. It's made up of a couple choruses and repeated phrases, but slowly builds throughout the track, and provides a really easy listen, while still standing out amongst the rest of the record. To start off the second half of the album, we get Second Life with Emily. The verses are very reminiscent of their EP, while the pre-chorus and chorus fits perfectly into the rest of the context of the album. While a little different at times, it still has a lot of great moments throughout the song, and is not one to be missed. Next up is Live at the Swamp. It's an incredibly upbeat and danceable song, discussing heavy drug use and romance, essentially being you and your friend's version of Chavu's Tide Turn. It's fun, and like a lot of these songs, just make you want to move. After that is the love-torn track, Shampoo Bottles. While starting out slow, it eventually builds into a grander chorus, and ends on a pleasant fade-out. Building off of Shampoo Bottles is Thursday, another ethereal cut. While slow, but steady in the verses, the chorus comes out of nowhere, with an anthemic snare that backs up the on-the-fence nature of the lyrics that describe a slowly declining relationship. Next is Your Teeth, a song that, while really, really pretty, is also quite strange. The verses are delivered in a pretty standard monotone fashion, only to transition into a strained ambient and echoed declaration of your teeth. It's interesting, I think, because it sort of takes and isolates a specific trait about this person he seems to have been in a relationship with in the past, wanting to take out his frustration on something without hurting this person, and thus really despising their teeth. It's a little goofy, but also romantic because of it, and I really like that. Finally, to end the record, we have You and Your Friends, a cut where I think their time with Two Door Cinema Club really shines. The song opens with a distorted and winding guitar riff, only to dissolve into bass and drums for the first half of the first verse. The song is structured incredibly well, and makes it a really good listen. It focuses on someone the narrator used to know, and how they often complain about everyone, taking the high horse and pushing themselves up while ignoring everyone else. Despite the cynical lyrics, the instrumentation is high and grand, and ends the record out on a really great note. This record did such a great job at taking a lot of the formulas and ideas that Peach Pit presented on Being So Normal, only to build on, improve, and arrange with a lot of other new concepts. Additionally, they've improved exponentially in their own genre of chewed bubblegum pop, something that I think, in retrospect, fits perfectly. Bubblegum pop is described as a genre of music with an upbeat sound contrived and marketed to appeal to preteens and teenagers, aka manufactured upbeat music meant to be marketed and sold to the youth. This is definitely apparent on a lot of the more upbeat and happy sounds on You and Your Friends. But at the same time, there's also a lot of genuine heartache, slow, sadder sounding tracks, and imperfections and distortions meant to skew that idea of perfect production throughout this album. It's happy at times, and sad at a lot of other points, which are often the times that shine the most. And thus, Chewed Bubblegum Pop becomes an idea of both idealism and fault, and embracing both in the spotlight. With this in mind, Peach Pit have perfected displaying their imperfections, and have had fun while doing so. When the album first came out, a blog that I often follow, Space Giraffe, put up a review of the record, which is going to be linked in the description, and something that I highly suggest you go read after this is over, that described it almost perfectly. Peach Pit make the music that you listen to in the park at 4 a.m. as a teenager with all your friends. The summer air is chilly and sweet, and the sun is just touching the horizon. The sky is black and blue. You will remember these moments for the rest of your life. You and your friends obnoxiously plays on an old CD/tape deck that you brought with you. You all take turns to take painful swigs from the bottle, and through the haze and confusion of intoxication, you talk about life. How much it sucks. Like, really sucks. You are naive, and you are only 16, but you are as old as you've ever been, and you already know everything you want to know about life. Peach Pit are master craftsmen of sad, introspective indie rock music that makes me want to awkwardly dance and quietly cry in equal measure. Like Alex said, Peach Pit have continued to capture the sound of dance, memory, and sadness beautifully under 12 incredible tracks, and it's something that I find trouble in describing my true, utter admiration for. I cannot recommend this album enough for those who have not heard it yet, because I honestly believe it will make you feel things you might not have felt before, and that is fucking beautiful. You and Your Friends is out now on all streaming services, and we have all the time in the world right now, so go give it a listen, and make some memories. Yeah, so that was Peach Pit. You and Your Friends is gonna be a contender for album of the year for me. The first time I actually decided to, I can't even say sit down and listen to the album, because I didn't. I went on a walk around a couple neighborhoods and just listened to this record, and it was incredible, because it was like in the middle of the day and the sun was shining. It was really, really nice. I ended up listening to it again, like I said earlier in the video, while in my car driving at night, and like they're two very different they're two very different surroundings, but I think they both help highlight the record itself, because like when you're driving and it's nighttime and the windows are down and like the sort of breaks in between Camilla I'm at Home are playing, it's really, really beautiful, I've really enjoyed listening to it like that. The usual message of these videos is listen to this, listen to this album, listen to this record, listen to this EP, listen to this artist. And so again, listen to it, it's good. That's pretty much gonna be all for me for now. The usual stuff, you know, thanks for subscribing. We're almost at 2,000 subscribers, which is pretty freaking cool. Dance Gavin Dance thing is still doing fun stuff. I've been enjoying releasing more videos more frequently recently. I'm assuming you guys have as well. Yeah. So if you did like this video, please leave a like. If you didn't, don't. Make sure to subscribe. And if you want to stick around for more, if not, then that's totally fine too. That's going to be all for me. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.